I have like the worst case that you throw right now because it's like killing me. Completely fine everywhere else, but it's like
it's like that one itch like in the like where you like talk and it still doesn't go away.
That's like the top, yeah, it's like the top of like my mouth in the back and like shit. I will say
like a split second though. I think it was
I was gonna say, if nothing else, I'm glad this tournament at least got me to wake up before like 5 o'clock.
Exactly. I can't sleep in because I have to get up for work every day at like 6.
Yeah. So. Well, that's why I kind of hate my job is like insanely inconsistent with the work schedule. So it's like, there's days where I literally don't have to come in until like 4, but then like, I'm working at night, and then like the next morning I have like something at 7. And I'm like, so like the summers for me are very chill, so like I have a lot of time to do stuff, so that's why like you'll see me like every single month.
My bad, I don't know why I
didn't.
Wait,
where do you work?
I'm an athletic director at Rochester College, so, like Rochester University, or Rochester Christian University, formerly Rochester University, formerly Rochester College.
Okay.
So. Well, the reason I say it like that is because every time I'll say one name and they don't know what it is, and then I'll
say
the other
name. They're like, oh yeah, I know what that is.
So,
is that why you like are able to host like the midnight?
Yeah, because I have to be Rita. So I just like I just want people to know that. But I got kind of done with doing that because like the midnight shit was killing me. I was like, dude, I just can't stay up this late.
Yeah, you get so tired.
Well, because they don't want to stop playing. I'm like sitting there, like there's no like time limit. I know it's like South Hills, like they have to get out, but they know like deep down it's really up to me. So like they start like pleading, and I'm like fine, we'll do one more. And then before you know it's like 4:30 in the morning.
Oh my God.
The first day we did it, it was 12. So we stopped. Our last game ended at 4.
That is so. You start at midnight, or you start? At
we started at midnight. And
you know, like every time you do like go, you start at midnight and then go for like.
Well, we pushed it back. We started pushing it back to 10 so more people could show up.
Okay.
And then we would go like, so we would go like 3 to 4 hours. So like there was one day I literally was like, I think it was like 2.5 hours in. I'm sitting there and I'm like, all right, we gotta go. Like I gotta work tomorrow. I made up some lie and I was like, we gotta go.
Like I'm sorry, guys.
Like, this is my first ever like tournament. So.
A lot of people show up.
We usually get like a full bus. Well, that's partly because Ryan Pyle in our group, like he has like 5 people he just automatically brings, and I'm like, all right. But I'm not complaining. Like, it's a good time.
Yeah.
But my issue is I'm trying to balance this with like lifting and basketball all at the same time, and it's like hard.
No time.
So I'll probably be playing basketball like tomorrow, and I play only full court, so like
fantastic.
Oh my
God!
Like that day that everybody like made fun of me. Like,
the
way I cramped, I had played volleyball the night before, lifted, and then the next day I did legs and like a little bit of a basketball workout in like the afternoon. Then I went and played basketball again at night, and then 2 hours into that, we were playing like full court nonstop. 2 hours in, I go to block the shot, and then in midair, both of my quads and my calf lock up completely, and I just went flat like that.
Oh my God.
And everyone's like confused. They're all like, "How the fuck did you do that?" And I'm like, "I can't move my leg."
3-4.
Yeah. So that was really funny.
Alright, here we go. 3-4.
So now I'm trying to figure out like how to balance it. But I think the lifting stuff I don't really care as much about, so I'm like kind of willing to get rid of that.
Yeah, I usually don't have like much going on in the summertime after work, so I'll probably go like sand volley.
What are you doing?
I'm a clinical research coordinator, so I work at a research site and do like clinical trials and like vaccines or anything that like the pharmaceutical companies want to approve.
Yeah.
But
yeah, I'm in a weird spot because I'm debating if I want to save this job or not. So the issue is, like, so my main title, like, I do all like the marketing and sports information stuff. So I'm like a sports information director. I'm one of like the top guys in our conference, and then I'm like the lowest paid guy. So I'm sitting there and I'm like, here's the problem though. So normally it'd be easy for me to just up and leave for a different job, but the problem is that kind of profession, the pay doesn't, like the pay scale is not that high. Like the next, like the highest guy makes 56, I make 40. And then, I live with my parents right now and the work works 5 minutes away. So like for me, it's like, I save a ton of money by just doing that. So I'm better off just staying versus like leaving. But then the problem is if I want to go get a master's and like, instead of, if I go to GA somewhere, that'd be like a huge step down career-wise. So it's like, it's a weird spot. Because I got hired in this job at 22, so like, it's like, and usually like the average hiring age for that job is like, I think like some of them are in their 40s usually. So I was sitting there and I'm like, I just don't know what to do. But I'll probably stick it out another year and then go get the master's.
What would you get your master's in?
MBA with probably a marketing concentration. But I'm also just debating if I even want to do it at all. Kind of, I know part of it is like my dad's really kind of like suggesting it. And I see why I would use it, but I'm also kind of like, with the networking I've done, with the people I've talked to, it's like I also don't feel like I necessarily need it either. But we'll see.
8-5.
Yeah, it sounds fully out.
I know, I can feel it.
And now I'm going to regret wearing a long sleeve shirt.
Especially black.
Yeah, I know.
9-5.
Well, I woke up 20 minutes before the tournament started, so I was like sitting there and I'm like, all right, what do I wear? And I was like, all right, just grab three things and you're done.
No, I set my alarm, I think it was 7:30,
and then I knew I was going to hit snooze. And I was like, okay, I'm set up for 7:30, and then I'll get up at 8. Because
I live like 15 minutes from here.
Yeah. I mean, I knew I wasn't
going to
eat breakfast, so I was like,
all right,
I guess whatever.
I had a yogurt, that was it. I was not going to eat something like, you know, very...
The thing is, I would take my shirt off, but then it's like my skin itches like crazy the moment it touches the grass. So I'm like sitting there and I'm like, I don't know if I want to deal with that the rest of the day. The fuck are we
like, my legs get like, yeah, kind of cut.
Oh, done, yeah.
I don't like break out in hives or anything. It's just like the small cuts on my legs. And when the sweat gets in it, it burns so bad.
Yeah. That's a pretty elite matchup over there. You get a lot of really good players on
that. I know. Phoenix, Romy. I don't know the one in the front left.
The guys on the other side are all pretty good too. Like the one guy next to Phoenix on the other side, he's like super athletic. I played with him in Porto.
Oh, yeah. No, he was on my team the first round. He was really good at hitting.
Hey, get there.
I'd love to get in like tournament organization stuff as like a side hustle thing. I'd definitely know they kind of set up tournaments around that.
That would be fun. Like, I know it like it takes a lot of like planning and
yeah.
Like figuring stuff out. I'm just like, I can't do it.
Yeah. I got asked to run the rec basketball league last year and I was like thinking about it and like they weren't gonna pay me and I'm like, alright, like fuck that. I'm not gonna
no,
that was like I would've been like a four, I mean, that would've been a 14-week commitment. I'm like, dude, you're the fuck out of here.
Like if you're not gonna get paid for it, yeah.
Yeah, like, sorry, guys.
I don't got that much time.
Yeah. I didn't have to figure out who's gonna be my team these next games because.
Me too.
I need to get back to 500 so bad.
You look at my number 13 and stop right. My letters.
13? Is it 13?
Yeah, 13.
That's your A.
A? Okay.
So I got Enoch.
Watch out.
Which number are you? Oh, I look at the wrong list. So you are B.
B, okay.
Next one. You are, is it 12? You're F. I'm like, what? I'm like, why'd you write dudes? I'm like, what?
Hey, everyone. everyone compares me to guys. Like, they're like, she plays like a guy, so she is one.
Hey, that's good.
Hey, that's what I said. I was like, I'll take that as a compliment. I got an older brother. He's 26. 27.
Fuck!
That's not right.
He doesn't play any sports, though. He used to play baseball and then football for like 2 years, but then he quit because he didn't like it anymore.
5'9"?
Oh, yeah. Getting tackled all the time. And, yep. He actually knocked out my front tooth, which was already going to come out anyways. When we were wrestling, and he elbowed me in the face on accident, and it just knocked it right out.
I got it.
I said, thanks, bro. Been trying to get that tooth out for a week.
All right. I really hope I get a win the next game, though.
If I lose,
then
it's
going to
be
3-3,
so it's like zeros.
Did you play a basketball shoot outside? Did you? Nice job. I'm saying, because those are the shoots that, those are the shoots he plays in South Carolina.
Are you talking about the one setting?
No, the one that's next to Julian on the other side.
Oh.
Right there, I got the ball. Yeah. Alex, you got it.
No, Josh decided that he wanted to be a little. Yeah.
I just said.
Yeah, he said the whole time.
Be me.
Because we asked
him. Now, let him know, Josh.
Josh, you don't have to do anything. I've got to
watch it.
I know.
I'm going to go grab mine. I know.
Yikes.
I was getting nervous when playing grad school, getting like some random rock somewhere.
Yeah.
I'm doing
what's
more like
have
like 5-1-2.
Or like
the
holes on
the field. Yeah, I had my toe. I was playing with you. I got caught. I think I got a pass to you, and then I got caught on the way up, and I was like, oh, shit.
I was getting nervous.
Yeah, we got really unlucky with that matchup too.
That
just sucks. It's like you're getting like the best, like really good left-handed hitter.
Yeah.
Like, really tough.
It's hard to block them.
I feel like I should have told you. But anyway, he was also like really good.